All right, so this is day two of the seminar. We're here with the elder David. Stop him. You can stop him, but just let him go on my hand. So David, what is your opinion from yesterday's seminar, day one? How'd you see that event? How'd you think that event took place and ended up based on your perspective?
Well, if you're a Christian, like I used to be, if you didn't go to church that Sunday, they always tell you, oh man, you should have been here last week. It was the best service. You always seem to miss the best services. So those of you who missed it yesterday, you missed a good seminar. So don't miss the next one.
Did you learn anything?
Yes, I did.
What did you learn?
Well, I learned about the social security numbers and them cards, or the dollar bill you had up there. Mm-hmm. And I learned that I could actually stand up in front of a room and not faint. So that was cool.
Okay. All right, let's pass the mic, man. All right, Cody, so what did you think of yesterday's seminar, man? This is day two. This is your second one, actually, here.
Yeah, second one in person, and second to none, these seminars. I've been to a lot of different venues, a lot of different seminars dealing in contracting commercially, and the information here is top-notch and second to none that you can find out there, and very informative, more than what was disclosed on the advertisement as far as what you're going to receive when you're here.
Right.
So anyways, and then about learning yesterday, I mean, we covered so many different things, but understanding more about how the courts are operating in trust.
Right.
The little you did touch on is some big key understanding that people don't understand, that trust law is literally controlling their life through contracts.
Right.
So, anyways, that's just happy to be here, happy everybody's here, you're in the right spot if you're here.
And Jim, Jim, where's your husband?
Is he in the room instead of the car? He was getting something out of the car last time I saw him. David said hi.
Hey, you can tell your husband to come on down.
Thank you.
Play like Price is Right and come on down. Yeah. Go ahead. Hold on. Put $10 on the table. We're going to need 10 bucks. Let's go to Jaideer. We're going to need 10 bucks on this guy, man.
Shalom.
No, so what did you think about yesterday's seminar? This is your first time, right? Yeah, this is your first seminar.
My first seminar?
Yeah.
Many webinars. Yeah, this is my first seminar. It's been a blessing so far. I got a lot of clarity on 1099A and 1099 OID. I got some clarity on the Social Security bond numbers. I did know that, but then I needed just a refresh. So
right.
It's good to go over these things again multiple times. So don't be discouraged if you didn't get it the first time, because you will see it again and again and again before you actually get it.
Right.
That's why you got to get the books. I got two new books to finish my collection, so I'm excited to get on that when I get back home. Praise be that we're all here. Hope everyone had a good night's rest, because we're about to get at it.
Is the gentleman next to you, is he your stylist?
Come on.
Mr. Body, is that your stylist?
I'm actually his stylist.
Okay. Oh, okay.
I'll pass it over to him.
I noticed the men that's dressed fresh as in the room is up front, adjacent to each other.
Shoulder to shoulder.
Nah, we don't want to use that term anymore. You better watch your wallet. You better watch your wallet. We don't want to use that, man. So, go ahead, Anthony.
Shalom. I appreciated this.
Stand up.
Jeremiah trying to use his size, man. A young bully, man.
Learning about the how to move in commerce. This is second seminar, but it was definitely good to see a refresher, because the first time you're not going to be able to retain everything. Like the brother here said before, I think it's important to get the books, just like you would get a textbook in college to refer. It's more important that you could go back, reread, and fully understand. So. I just want to say I appreciate it. Oh, and also I also appreciate you bringing this back to scripture as well to show how this is more of a spiritual journey, more so than a fleshly journey.
Cool. Appreciate it, brother.
Yo, how y'all doing? How y'all doing?
We doing good, brother. What about you?
Good.
Every day, always a perfect day.
Oh, yeah, new day.
What was your name again, King?
Caleb.
Caleb.
Yeah.
All right.
Just came back. A lot of information yesterday, but I ain't even gonna lie. Like, I got it all, but we gonna try. We gonna keep trying. I bought a book yesterday, so came back. We gonna go at it again. Try to retain some of this information.
Right. Here, here. Terrence.
Shalom, shalom, everybody.
Shalom.
This is my second seminar, countless webinars. Got to keep it going. You're not going to retain it all. I don't care who you are. You're not going to retain it all the first go around, but just stick with it. I brought one of my sons. I was supposed to bring my brother. I'll bring the other two next time, so. Keep it going, everybody.
Come. It was all a dream. I used to read Word Up magazine. Biggie, they is your Biggie back reincarnated. I love it when they call me Big Papa. Yeah, come on, man. Y'all can't tell me he don't resemble Biggie, man. He got the same
a webinar too. The seminar definitely different experience. I'm going to try to write a little bit faster today than I did yesterday so I can try to get more information. But I like this school, just something to learn. Get to it.
Hey, wait, brother. Damn, where's Carefoot?
Shalom, family.
Shalom.
Morning. My name again is David, family of Tamabosa. Traveled from Washington State. Yesterday, I learned how to acquire back my energy. Fiat dollars through the 1099A and 1099 OID. More importantly, I got to see the Tazadaq, Kahan Tazadaq, and the rest of the family. So I'm very thankful and grateful for that.
I got a question for you, David. What did you think about Purim, those scriptures you was going over?
Oh, yeah, I missed the Purim. I apologize for that, everyone.
Yeah, but David, your pizza damn sure did taste good.
Appreciate you guys, though.
All right, man. All right, appreciate it, man. Hey, give it to Michael. Give it to Michael, man. Richard, let Mike get it right now. So, what did you think about it yesterday, Mike? Oh, Mike's hiding, man.
Oh, stand up on the chair real quick. You're too little. There you go. You're good. That's good. That's good.
So what did you think about yesterday, Mike?
Yeah, talking to the mic. Put the mic by your chin.
He's thinking right now. He's processing. Remember yesterday, 10 minutes, he came back with a thing. Well, I'm not Michael. I'm a Xavier. When I walked in today, they kept saying, I'm Michael. I'm Xavier. I'm Michael. I'm Xavier. So what'd you think yesterday, Mike?
What'd you think about Purim?
No comment, huh?
Did you like the pizza?
Yes.
What about those Oreos? There we go. What you think about those Oreos, Mike?
It was fine.
All right. Let's see what Xavier has to say.
Stand up.
What about you, Xavier? What do you think about the Purim?
I think it's good.
All right. What do you think about the Oreos? Vanilla and chocolate.
Wow. Brilliant.
You said brilliant?
Brilliant.
Oh, wow. Where did you get that from?
All right, let's give it back to Richard, man. Hand it back to Uncle Richard behind you there.
I guess it was about the seminar or the career.
Yeah, I guess both, man. I don't know. It was trying to get into feedback.
As far as the seminar, I'm very appreciative of the opportunity to stay abreast on the information. Because, man, if you don't use it, you lose it in type of situation. So, that's my appreciation on that end. And as far as morale, the appreciation of the situation.
Can't hear you.
That's the situation where
here we go.
You know, vying for the Jews in front of the king to be able to hold up for what they were standing for. And appreciate
it. Who's next?
Miss Chan, Miss Chan, go ahead, Miss Chan. Miss Chan, can some of y'all?
Shalom, my name is, I'm sorry, Shalom.
Shalom.
What I learned yesterday was just do it. Just do the process.
Right.
You know? And do it and have fun with it. Be creative with it. Like, what I learned from yesterday was, there was a lot of cast filling. A lot of, they were doing a lot of, what they, what I've learned was just do the paper and just do it.
Alright.
Thank you.
Alright, thank you.
Shalom, brothers and sisters.
Shalom.
I'm Derek from yesterday, first seminar. But I learned he who does not deny it admits it.
Right.
Cool. And an unrebutted affidavit stands as truth.
Right.
A lot of most stuff, you know, that I ain't gonna take up the time, but I'm getting it in, you know. So that's, you know, I'm ready for today and get some more, you know. So that's all I gotta say.
So I appreciate it, Ken. Appreciate it.
Eric. Shalom, everybody.
Shalom.
My name is Eric White. I've been to a couple of seminars. I enjoyed each and every one of them. Yesterday in particular, what I learned was interesting to find out that you can, I can, from a credit report through the tax forms, I can discharge stuff from a credit report, and a whole lot of other kind of stuff.
Cool.
I enjoyed it.
So, all right.
Look forward to this. Thank you.
Nice.
Okay, shalom everyone. Peace, shalom.
Shalom, King. Shalom. Shalom.
All right. Yesterday was very enlightening. I learned a lot about dealing more on the public and private side when it comes to you know, different businesses and stuff like that. I got aware about using the 1099 form because I was only aware of it using it one way, and I got introduced in a whole other way to use it so far as discharging debt. And this is my second seminar, so each one is very enlightening in so far as what you can learn and how you can take control of your straw man. So yeah, definitely informative. Enjoy it. Looking forward to learning some more.
Appreciate it.
Shalom. Shalom.
Shalom.
Yeah. Now, can you tell us in a rhyme, man, in a rap, man, what you won yesterday? MC Jehote, man. It's really good, man. We're doing studio time.
We ain't gonna do that. We ain't gonna do that. But I learned a lot yesterday. This is my second seminar I have attended. I learned a lot both times. But the most important thing that I have to say I learned was do not reserve your rights on an affidavit. That was real crucial thing for me, because I just did it, you know. I bought the books, watched the videos, and I just did it. And I noticed that there were certain things I was doing that wasn't really right, so I had to correct that. And also, I purchased this book yesterday. I don't know if you can see that.
Absolutely.
But, cracked it open this AM. I'm simultaneously reading three books at a time. One being The Corporation, the other being Edom and Gazaria, first Hebrew Israelites and this one. So I said, shalom.
Shalom. This is my first seminar, but I've been to countless webinars, and I can say from webinar to seminar, this is way better. Just in terms of the way I learn, is being up close and personal with the information in front of you. Visual, you get the visual, you get the audio with the Kahana speaking, and stopping and being able to explain things that you're actually reading on the screen. It's one thing to read from the books, but it's another to be in front in person with the man who wrote the book. So that was good. We also went over public versus private, and really to understand that we're in the private, in this meeting, to understand how to operate within the public. Just so many other things, along with being able to fellowship with Akim, with Purim. It's just a blessing. And, you know, I'm Barak. I'm Barak. So,
bless.
I thank everybody for being here. And, I'm going to get it in on
Tawab.
Oh, he already went? And stand up, Walid. You next. Stand up. Shoulder to shoulder.
Little funny stuff, man. Uh-huh. Go and check my snacks in the back, man. Go and check my drinks. Walid is in the belt. And is it, when his head is turned 45 degrees like that, he's on the plow again. So watch your bones.
Fucking shalom, man. Glad to be here, each and every member here. I don't have a name. I have a godly attribute. Who is the paramount security holder of the entity known as W.D. Merriweather.
Oh, here we go.
And I am really, I got chills just being here with you people, because everyone that I talk to, especially the Kahan, has given me something to walk out of this place with, and I can appreciate that. In that, you giving me what you giving me, I can say you all, brothers and sisters, and say, I got family. Because my blood family, I don't have none. I don't have no mother, father, uncles, aunts, cousins, all of them are gone. So that's what you've become to me by how you spoke with me.
That man, he could pitch his way out of hell. Right.
I'm trying to tell you, man.
That boy could pitch to the devil. That's a hell of a pitch right there. He almost had me for his pitch. I almost believe what he was saying.
Man.
The Kahan says he hears fire coming out of my voice. But I want to let the world know, just looking at this video, he did it. He put fire.
Now he's
studying
so like Chris
Howell.
He put
the dogs, man.
I wish you well. The
wind is 36
feet deep.
Don't need to say that part, Riley. Well, in jest, you may say comment on my character, but I'm standing on my square. And once again, I say it's because of you. I am where I am. That's you. In pursuit of righteousness. I just want to be right. Ever how wrong the de facto say I am, I still hold on to the concept, I just want to be right. Thank you, God.
Thank you, bro. It's good. Hey, Wally, before you hand him that, can you check him for wires? I think he might be wearing a wire.
right.
Look how warm it is. He got this. He got this shirt.
Kind of thin.
So he got wires on.
And the mic gonna start staticking again.
Man, he's an agent. Well, watch, if the mic starts staticking, that wire is somewhere.
Shalom, everybody. My name is Scott Sam Greenley.
I thought you said Scott
yesterday.
Scoot.
I
stand.
I got you.
Oh, all right, I got you.
That's
his alias. He's telling us who he is, man.
Yeah.
You guys don't know he's talking about the spook that slipped behind the door? Yeah, that was that so-called black man that infiltrated the FBI
and posed it like he wanted to be an FBI agent, but he went in and got the information. He got trained by the FBI.
Whoa.
Then he went back into the ghetto and he created a lot of.
Yes, he did.
Yeah, and you know, they was causing havoc like all over the cities or whatever. But they thought he was a legitimate guy. He was clean cut, all of that. So, you know, they trusted him. Mm-hmm. He got his way inside, and he trained a lot of militants to fight against the FBI. Even when I got a Nicholas Carefoot, he said, no, we can use him. We need him to be able to infiltrate. Yeah, real talk, man. That's a good movie. You should watch it. It's called The Spook That Stood Behind the Door.
Yeah, I do encourage you. I watched it last night again. In fact, I watched the actual person who did it, Sam Green. He had to go to make that movie.
Right.
It came out and then it went away.
But well, I got a copy of it, man.
Yeah, we want it on YouTube. But again, I appreciate everyone being here, learning a lot. I appreciate the friendship and relationships that are developing here. Yeah, this is a journey.
It's a journey, man.
It's a journey. And I hope I can internalize this knowledge and information and pass it on.
Appreciate you, brother. Yeah.
Shalom, everyone.
Shalom,
family. What I learned yesterday was a lot about the 1099 OID process. It was very complicated for me to understand. So just reading about it in the books and coming to the seminar and seeing it live up on the screen and being explained and questions asked just gives me clarity. A lot of clarity. And I enjoyed the Purim last night. It was my first Purim. Learned a lot about that. Just learning about the scriptures is new to me. And I'm still learning. I'm loving it. Glad to be here.
Appreciate you.
Shalom.
This is my first event. First seminar. I'm gonna make sure to have it. Just for my journey. I learned a lot yesterday, but one thing that just stuck with me as far as the social security card, how one side is private, one side is public. That intrigued me a lot. I'm very grateful. And I didn't attend for him. I just plan on learning as much as I can from you guys. I'm just grateful to be here. Just for this moment for me.
So,
no
doubt, appreciate you.
Shalom, family. Shalom. This is my second seminar. Last one was my first one. And it's just constant knowledge.
Say your name.
I'm sorry, I apologize. My name is
Manny. Joe Castro.
My name is Manny.
Come on.
I'm from the country of Florida.
Shea Kavar.
And yesterday, it was very informative, but to me, I'm more on a spiritual journey more than anything, because all this other stuff is a bonus to me. Because I feel like if you ain't in the right spiritual mind, you ain't never going to get any of this.
Cool. Yep.
And Purim yesterday really opened my eyes, my first Purim. And just that fellowship, man, I left craving more. And because of that, I want to read a little Bible verse, 1 Peter, 2nd chapter. It says, wherefore laying aside all malice and all guile and hypocrisies and envies and all evil speakings, as newborn babes desire the secure milk of the word, that ye may grow thereby. And if so be ye have tasted that the Lord is gracious. And I feel like he's been very gracious and blessed me very much with the prayer.
Come on.
Hello everyone.
Hello.
My name is Jeusus. I learned a lot in the seminar, but most importantly what impacted me was the print. It was my first time attending that, and it was life-changing, the scriptures and memory experience, a study like that on the scriptures. And it was just something that I felt like the Most High put me here for that more than anything. I got everything else going on, but the Most High has got me here, and it's got me here for a reason. And I'm blessed to be around everybody who's here too, seeking. He's got you here.
Cool.
call.
Shalom, y'all.
Shalom.
Sequoia.
Shout out to the elder Taha.
Nah. I'm pretty much trying to stand on my own now. You know. So basically, I enjoyed the room yesterday. One thing that stood out in the webinar was the quote, "He who is asking is as king." Mm-hmm. And then I thought about it, and I thought about it last night, like, man, a lot of these conversations we have with these public officials, it's like we're entering contracts verbally, you know what I'm saying? By, instead of asking questions, we go argue, you know what I'm saying?
Not necessarily verbally, though. Someone defined the word verbally. It's viva voce. Verbally doesn't always mean what you think. So we got to be real clear on what. Someone look define the word verbally.
Con the black wall.
Is verbally always audible?
No.
You got to look up all of these words.
Gotcha.
Yeah, it was a good opportunity for me to try to elaborate.
I got you.
Okay.
Strictly of or pertaining to words, expressed in words.
Okay, so verbally doesn't mean it has to be vocally or people will say by voice. It could just be words, right? Doesn't necessarily have to be enunciated. Go ahead.
Whether spoken or written.
So verbally could also mean written, see? Most people think they understand language, but they don't. Like I said, it's aphasia. We need a lobotomy. Everything that we learn, we have to relearn again. So, the correct enunciation should have been viva voce, by voice. Look that up, viva voce. That's vocally, by voice.
Viva voce.
It's Latin. Remember, most of this war stuff comes from Latin. It goes back to Rome. Which goes back to what? The papacy. The Pope.
The Vatican.
Yeah, the Vatican.
Viva voce with the Viva voce led with the living voice.
That's with the voice. So when we've been taught in common parlance, if we say something's verbal, we think we're speaking it. It could mean you're writing it down.
By
all these little
or
things
mouth.
Are very important in law, man.
How's
it
spelled? Viva voce.
V-I-V-A.
It's a Latin word. Tell me how to spell it, Jeremiah.
V-I-V-A-V-O-C-E.
And you know what's ironic? People hear me say this stuff all the time on YouTube, but they never pay attention to it. They just say, he's just saying verbally. No, I'm not.
Mm-hmm.
So that's why I told people every word that I say is didactic. It's meant to teach something. But it goes over most people's head.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Were you done?
Yeah,
he's done.
Oh, okay.
Shalom, family.
Shalom.
Bon Yahawada, Bon Yashalom. Authorized representative of LeVar Curtis Johnson. Yesterday, I learned a lot from watching The Twilight Zone. And one thing that stuck out yesterday was in the Purim, he was speaking as far as the name. He said something to a gentleman and then replied to him as Thomas. And he was like, "Who is Thomas?" So it's like, with the Most High, you got to get that name right. Probably. If you don't have it, it's like walking into a grocery store saying mom.
Right.
So.
Hey, you and Piggly Wiggly. You ain't going to get mama's cookies, you ain't going to get pork.
Nothing. I just encourage everyone to make it to these seminars.
They laughing, but they have a Piggly Wiggies out here, man.
Yeah.
Yeah, they have it in North Carolina. I seen it with a 95.
Yep.
I encourage everyone to make it to these seminars because you're going to receive 50 times over. Whatever you pay, or it's just the information is here.
Okay.
If you don't make it, you need to try your best to do what you got to do to get here. Shalom.
Shalom. JB, the young bully.
Yep.
Stand up.
So good.
So
good. So good.
Jeremiah Banks, the young bully with the patience of Gary Coleman.
My name is Jeremiah Banks. I've been studying with Akon for almost a year now. You know, I learned a lot in the last seminar, this seminar, you know, just being around Akon, you know, you're going to learn a lot of information and just, you know, feed off this energy. Just everything, just commercial presentments, how to respond, you know, contract is law, law is contract. He's been beating that over our heads for years, you know. It's just an offer, you can, no matter how they word it, how they try to say it, or in a threatening way, it's just an offer. And it's not what they say, it's what they do. And it's all about how you respond. Are you going to, you know, acquiesce? You know, acquiesce is this agreement. If you don't say anything, do anything, or you're in agreements or whatever commercial presentment that they sent you. But, you know, you should be conditionally accepting the offers, you know, for information purposes only. Yeah, I just been studying, you know, so many different things, discharge of debt, EFT, AFB, 1099, turning, you know, they send you a bill, you can turn it into a money order, endorse it, getting rid of warrants, accepting it for value, return for value, just so much different stuff you can learn, and it's very just, you know, life-changing information, and I'm just happy I came across the Kahan. I was looking at how I first got into it. I was looking at like some of the right to travel stuff, and I was seeing people like basically present passports and like, you know, get left alone. And I kind of just came across one of the Kahan's videos and attending webinars, finally seminars, and just all type of stuff, going into court, you know, presenting affidavits, you know, using my assumed name. I haven't done my SBC packet yet, but I do have an assumed name, which I got from a seminar last May. And, you know, it creates a distinction between the legal entity and the secure party, the aggrieved man. And, you know, it's just a lot. So I'm just happy to be here, still learning, you know, just trying to soak up as much information as I can and, you know, stay out of trouble. Yeah, shalom.
What you think about Purim?
The Purim, very informative. That's another thing that I want to get into. Like, not just the commercial side, but the spiritual aspect as well, you know, for to be carnally minded is death, but to be spiritually minded is life. Trying to, you know, balance both that as well. I like how you tie everything into the scriptures as well. He tell you, you know, this is all spiritual.
Come on.
You know, that's why a lot of people, they come around for the commerce and then kind of just drop off of, you know, this doesn't work, you know, they wasn't in the right mindset. He always say, you know, you got to get your mind right first. It's about how you think, you know. What are you in this for? What are you trying to, you know, get up out of this? But definitely, I've been trying to study the scriptures to be a part of two disciples of Christ, and just both sides. And yeah, it was a good experience. And yeah.
Come.
Shalom.
Nicholas Kerf.
Stand up. Good, you're good.
I am the author's representative. Hired by Carefa Trust for NPC and Associates. I was referred to this man, the authorized representative for Tazadaq, in 2016 because I was a reprobate. And since then, I have began believing in the Most High. And also from this seminar, especially yesterday, I really enjoyed Purim. I've never been invited to any of the High Holy Days before, so I made sure to make it Hades or High Waters, so I made it somehow, and I'm here. And, you know, it was, I think Purim was really, 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 really good, and I learned a lot, actually, and more so the seminar, as always, very, very informative, and, you know, there's a lot to take away, and so, you know, some of that information, even yesterday, I needed for something I was dealing with. So, you know, it's always good to keep studying this contract law stuff and stay in the ecclesiastical law, because at the end of the day, that's really all that's gonna save you is yourself. So, shalom.
Shalom. All right, we got everybody on this side.
Just warden. Yeah, so let's go over something real quick. We're gonna talk about, Did people realize in the scriptures that there was a fake Jesus that most people, I don't say Jesus, Yahushua, that most people today worship, and they think they're worshiping the Messiah? So, no, not him.
there was a man that literally carried the attribute, and he was from the tribe of Judah. He went by the name of Simon. Let's get Acts, the 13th chapter. A lot of people read the Bible, they don't even see this. They don't realize it. And then, you can pull it up in your Sephora.
Acts
13. So, no, you ain't got it.
No, he, Benai's got it. Yeah, he got it.
Verse 1?
Yeah, so this man, he was from the tribe of Judah. He was a sorcerer. So that means he appeared to have the ability to work miracles, just like a Mashiach, right? So he was healing people, and he was doing miraculous things. So they looked to him as a Christ. And he carried the attribute, as you're going to see, the son of Yahusha, right? He was the son of Yahusha. And a lot of Christians, I'm going to say every Christian read the Bible, but they never catch this. They never see it. So still reading that verse 1 up.
It's the book of Acts.
Chapter. Well, first, someone, give me, get 2 Corinthians 11 and 4. Let's start with that. So we can see that it was prophesied, it was supposed to be a fake Messiah.
I got that.
They start worshiping a fake Messiah. I got it.
The book of 2 Corinthians, chapter 11, verse 4. For if he that cometh preacheth another Hamashiach, whom we have not preached.
Okay, stop. So the prophecy is saying that someone may come preaching of another Savior that the true biblical Israelites never heard of. So it was prophesied that this was happening, right? And that's who most people worship today. They call him Jesus, JC, Christ, and so on and so forth.
Okay. Or if ye receive another spirit.
So this guy, he had a ruach, a different spirit, right? But it wasn't holy. It was not the Ruach HaKadosh. So everyone has a spirit. There's all kind of spirits, right? Mm-hmm. But it's the Ra Ta'kamah, which means unclean spirit, right? So this man carried an attribute and like attributes of Christ, but he wasn't Christ. He was evil. And he was the Ra Ta'kamah, which means unclean spirit.
Which ye have not received, or another gospel, which ye have not accepted, ye might well bear with him.
And so that's pretty much what's going on. The vast majority of Christians accept this guy. They don't know the real Yahusha. So what I want to point out, Christ or Yahusha never told any of us to worship him, ever. But this man, this particular man that they now call Jesus, you will see that he wanted people to worship him. You know, he wanted people to pay homage to him. So read what you got, Acts 13 chapter from the top.
Come on, this is the book of Acts, chapter 13, verse 1. Now there were in
it. It's bested. Well, it's going to be wobbly again like that. All right, but you got it. Got it. So what?
Now there were in the church that was at Antioch.
So where's Antioch? Anyone know where Greece. Antioch is? Greece. On the map? What would that be called today? That's Upper Syria. That's Upper Syria. Antioch is Upper Syria. That's the first place where the Israelites was actually called Christians. And you'll find out they was called Christians because they was worshiping this false Messiah. It was worshiping this false Messiah, right? That carried the attribute of Bon Yahusha, meaning son of Christ. Got to read.
Was at Antioch certain prophets and teachers.
Okay, certain prophets. And then this man, he was a false prophet. So in order for someone to be a prophet, right? I mean, a false prophet, that means someone has to be looking to him as a prophet, right? For him to carry the attribute of a prophet. But he was a false prophet, and he had a lot of followers. And the people, the kings, and everyone, they accepted him. As Hamashiach. Got it.
As Barnabas and Simon that were called...
Now, this man, Simon, is the one that was a sorcerer. You're going to find out. He was a sorcerer, and people was worshiping him as the Messiah. Got it. Most Israelites, nobody catch this. Great.
That was called Niger... And
so he was an Israelite. Mm-hmm. He was called Niger, which means modern day term, Inwa. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. Niger. It means he was dark. You can look it up, man. Mm-hmm.
And Lucius of Cyrene and Mananim, which had been brought up with Herod the Tetrarch and Saul. Verse 2. As they ministered to the Supreme Allah and fasted, the Ruach HaKadosh said, separate me from Barnabas and Saul, for the work whereunto I have called them.
And so when he said to separate me from Barnabas and Saul, so remember Saul's name is eventually changed to Paul. Mm-hmm. Paul was starting to take on this also, man. Okay, read.
And when they had fasted and prayed and laid their hands on them, they sent them away. Mm-hmm. Verse 4. So they being sent forth by the Ruach HaKadosh departed unto Seleucia, and from thence they sailed to Cyprus.
Watch this. Got it.
Verse 5. And when they were at Salamis, they preached the word of Yahweh in the synagogues of the Jews, and they had also Yochanan, John, to their minister. Verse 6. And when they had gone through the isle unto Paphos, they found a certain sorcerer.
Okay, now this man is a sorcerer. Now, a sorcerer is someone that practices what? Witchcraft. And he has people bewitched. So, remember they used to call Hamashiach, they say he was a sorcerer because he was able to work miracles. So, again, a sorcerer is also like a miracle worker. He appears to work miracles to people.
Appears.
Yeah, right? If you don't believe in miracles, they call it sorcery or they call it magic, right? So this guy was a true sorcerer. That means he was a witch. And he had a lot of the Israelites bewitched. Gotta read.
And when they had gone through the isle unto Paphos, they found a certain sorcerer, a false prophet.
Oh, see, he was a false prophet. So that means people had to be worshiping him as a prophet. He's a false prophet. Gotta read.
A false prophet, a Jew.
So he, a what?
A Jew.
So he was from the tribe of Judah. He was from the tribe of Judah. Read on. So that just like Hamashiach was from the tribe of Judah. Mm-hmm. This is a Christ that only Christians are worshiping today. They're worshiping this man, Simon. They carried the attribute of son of Yahusha, a son of Yahusha. Okay.
Whose name was Bar Yahusha.
So but that means son. They put a misnomer there. The word should have been Bon or Ben, meaning son. You go look at, what does your Bible say in your supper? It probably has son right there.
It says Bar Yahusha, but on the description of lexicon, it says of a Hebrew origin, son of Yahusha.
See that? See, I'm not making this up. So son of Yahusha. So he carried the attributes.
What is that prefix, Bar? Son of?
Yeah, no, it means son. Just like Bon. See, in Paleo Hebrew is B-A-N. Gone. And modern Hebrew is B-E-N. Meaning son of.
I seen a Ben. Yeah. Gone.
Yeah, but the Ben is just a modern Hebrew interpretation of transliteration.
Were you saying Paleo was Bar or what?
Ben.
Bon.
B-A-N.
Okay,
here's
a Bar.
Yeah, that has a misnomer there. Also.
Hebrew it says Bar dash Jesus.
Right, that means Yahusha. Right, so that means son of Yahusha. That's the attribute that most Christians don't notice. They don't pay attention. They skip over the Bible, man. They don't know me, no.
I remember Simon. I know Simon.
Yeah, literally. Yeah. I've never seen it
from the past. But they worship him as the Messiah. That's, and that's who people worship in the day. Okay, read on.
Verse 7, which was the deputy of the country, mm-hmm. Sergius Paupus, a prudent man, who called for Barnabas and Saul, and desired to hear the word of Yahweh. Mm-hmm. Billy Lamas.
Now, Paul's going to say, yo, man, you are the devil, man. But where are you coming from with this? You a devil. Paul called him a demon. Okay, read.
But Lamas, the sorcerer, for so
it is. The sorcerer. See, now, what's his name? See, he's carrying many attributes.
Yes.
You see that? Now they start calling him something else. What are they calling him right there?
Elamas.
Someone look up the word Elamas. Like, see what that points back to. Like, points right back to this man out of the tribe of Judah. So he could fake it. He could say I'm the Christ because he came out of the tribe of Judah just like Yahweh did. Yahusha. But you got what you got?
First century AD, also known as Bar Jesus.
See? That's him. Son of Yahusha.
That's great.
See, that's it. Nobody catches it, man.
Because
they're not moving in the right road. So go ahead, read.
See how they switch the name up? Christian, I don't mean nothing. It's the same potion. Right. It's right there. They read it, they never knew it. They worship in this man, that's what they worshiped in the dead. Mm-hmm. Now, every Christian is worshiping this man as Yahusha,
so
as a savior.
The disciples were sending, were spreading the word across Paul and them. They were spreading the word. And when they came up to Antioch, that's when they first started calling.
That's when they started using that term, man. That's the only time that term Christ came out. There was first called, and the disciples was first called Jews, I mean Christians, in Antioch, in this place right here. Because they stood, they was worshiping this guy right here. They was worshiping him. So you got something?
Yeah, I got a precept here. Isaiah 19:3. And the Ruach of Mitzrayim shall fall in the midst thereof, and I will destroy the council thereof. And they shall seek to the idols, and to the charmers, and to them that have familiar spirits, and to the wizards.
See that? Mm-hmm. And they all worshiping it. They were worshiping this man. The man was a sorcerer, but to them, it appeared that he was working miracles.
Familiar spirits.
Right, familiar spirits.
Wow.
Okay.
But Elamus the sorcerer, so is his name
Elamus ben Yahusha, the sorcerer, son of Yahusha. Okay.
So is his name by interpretation, withstood them, seeking to turn away the deputy from the faith.
So he's trying to turn the sincere believers away from the faith. He wanted them to worship him, and they did. Okay.
Verse 9. Then Saul, who was also called Paul, filled with the Ruach HaKadosh, set his eyes on him. Verse 10. And said, O full of all subtlety and all mischief, thou child of the devil, thou enemy of all righteousness.
See, Paul was calling him everything. Child. Yeah, child of the devil. Thou child of the devil.
Not son.
The child of perdition.
Keep that. Okay.
Wilt thou not cease to pervert the right ways of Yahweh? And now, behold, the hand of Yahweh is upon thee, and thou shalt be blind, not seeing the sun for a season. And immediately there fell on him a mist and a darkness. And he went about seeking some to lead him by the hand. Verse 12. Then the deputy, when he saw that what was done, believed, being astonished at the doctrine of the Supreme Allahan.
So everyone started to believe from the king on down. They started believing in this man, Simon, man. Simon, son of Yahusha.
Wait, how did his name keep changing? Is it through time?
We call him, it's just a different interpolation. It says a transliteration. That was a transliteration of the name.
Like Yahweh Shai has many names.
Yeah.
Crazy because my grandma goes to this church called Antioch.
But I mean, there's nothing wrong with Antioch. That's just Upper Syria. Yeah, they just changed the name of it. Yeah. So we can see, let's go to Acts 8, verse 9, man. We can see this guy, man. They sort of worship him. Acts 8, verse 9. What you got? Hey, let him read it. You got the mic right there. You can get Matthew 1 and 21. You can see that. The role y'all.